discuss about the postgraduate degree program MBA, that is Master of Business Administration. Let me first explain what an MBA is. So, Master of Business Administration is a postgraduate degree that provides students theoretical and practical knowledge about management and various business-related aspects. It focuses on developing managerial, leadership, technical, and various entrepreneurial skills of the students. MBAs can choose their own area of specialization like finance, marketing, human resource, and operations, and supply chains. Now, let us look at the reasons that lead you to do an MBA, to do this degree course. Let's look at the benefit of pursuing MBA as your career. So, it provides you better career opportunity. As you know, only an undergraduate program does not provide you a wide scope of opportunities. So, MBA for you increases the opportunities. It ensures high salary potential. You can earn more after completing your MBA program. Start your own company from scratch. You can start your own startup. You can make your own company. Enhance knowledge in your specialization. For example, if you have done BCom honors in your graduation, you can do MBA in finance. That will help you enhance your knowledge in the field and get a good job in that field only. It helps you in shifting your career. I have seen students who have done hotel management in their undergraduate program, and then they wanted to shift from that career to get better salary. So they do MBA in various other specializations so as to increase their opportunities. It helps in personality development. Various case studies and various business talks and guest lectures are organized in MBA program that help you in developing your personality. Helps in developing entrepreneurship values. Various case studies and GDs, that is group discussions held in the MBA program, lead you in understanding the business environment more deeply, which help you in inculcating entrepreneurship values. It opens door to reach the top hierarchy. As we all know that to reach top hierarchy in an organization, certain fixed degree is for the eligibility criteria. So MBA enables an individual to reach that top hierarchy. It helps in running and enhancing family business. If you are running a family business, then you can pursue MBA and enhance your family business and lead to greater profits in the future. It improves strategic thinking of individuals. The case studies and business scenarios that are developed in the classroom only lead you to help you in dealing with the real life business scenarios, and then you develop a thinking that helps you in finding strategic solutions to business scenarios. What is the difference between MBA and PGDM? Please remember that MBA and PGDM are two different courses, just like these two different routes going different ways. So first, diploma and degree difference. PGDM, that is postgraduate diploma in management, is a diploma and MBA is a degree. But that does not make much of a difference. What you must focus is to pursue any of them from a good institution only. Syllabus and curriculum. In PGDM, it focuses more on the practical aspects of the curriculum, whereas MBA is more theoretical in nature. Accreditation. Before going for a PGDM, you must check for accreditation by different universities, as various frauds are committed by various institutions. But in MBA, there is no such risk of accreditation. Fees. In PGDMs, fees is usually much higher whereas in MBBS the fees is usually less because these universities are supported by the government. Focus of the diploma or degree. So the focus of PGTM program is to help you inculcate these skills so as to deal with the practical aspects of the business, whereas MBA is more theoretical in nature. Multidimensional teaching. Through various case studies in PGTM program, students gain more knowledge about the practical aspects. So, but in MBA, there is no such thing. Ranking. PGTM colleges have much higher ranking than MBA in India. Entrance exam. The entrance exam conducted in both are usually the same. However, for MBA, various other state level exams are conducted by different universities. How to get in? What are the eligibility criteria? So this is the list of entrance exams for MBA that are being conducted, except for GMAT. GMAT is accepted only in IIMs, that are Indian Institute of Management, as well as GMAT is accepted in universities abroad. So this is the first thing that students must look after. Also, while taking admission, your 10th, 12th and your graduation scores are also considered. Next thing that is being work experience is not a compulsory thing to have, but it gives you a plus point among others. Writing ability test. It is conducted in many of the IIMs, in usually all of the IIMs and even private colleges. Group discussions are a must. They are held in every good institution and extempore in some colleges like FMS, that is Faculty of Management Studies. Personal interviews are held in almost every good institution. So you must have to prepare for all these if you want to get admission in good college. List of top colleges offering MBA. This is the list of top colleges which offer MBA or PGTM program. Most of them are offering PGTM, as in even Indian Institute of Management offer PGTM program. And only FMS is the one and most reputed college that offers MBA program. And these are various related courses that you must do if you do not get into a reputed college, because if you get in a reputed college, then there won't be any need of doing all these. The college will itself provide you everything and you won't need to do any extra courses. MBA in India versus MBA abroad. So what is the difference? Cost of study is much higher in abroad than in India. Work experience is a must in abroad, but it is not in India. Syllabus and curriculum is almost the same. However, in abroad, practical exposure is much higher than in India. Placement in abroad depends completely on the student, and student has to grab the opportunities on the basis of their own networks only. Whereas in India, colleges like IIMs provide good placement opportunities to students. Entrance exams for abroad are different. They are GMAT and GRE. Average salaries in abroad go up to 20 lakh to 70 lakh per annum, whereas in India, average salary ranges from 7.5 lakh to 20 lakhs per annum. Distance MBA is best suited for those who are already working somewhere, so then they can choose for that. So the merits of distance MBA are that you can reschedule classes, you can learn and earn at the same time, the cost is very low, and there is no competition as such. However, the demerits are that there will be no networking, there will be no discipline, as you will be procrastinating your classes a lot, and there will be no discipline. No placements are provided to you and the exposure is very less. Not ready for MBA or PGTM?
here is a list of different courses that you can pursue if you are not ready for MBA or PGDM. That's all for today. Thank you.